Thank you so much for being back here. I want to start by saying there are going to be some spoilers. So if you are not caught up on Game of Thrones, you may wish to keep the show on this channel. Don't turn or turn to another one, but maybe cover your ears, okay?
That would be good, yes.
That would be good.
Or mute. They could mute.
Yes. Yes, you could. Well, actually, most people watch my show on mute anyway. My voice has been proven to be highly irritating. I'm going to start by saying that in one of the most recent episodes, again, Game of Thrones did not disappoint. You made a bold move, and you killed King Joffrey. And I have to say, look at that.
It was another wedding.
It was another wedding. Man, your weddings are awful. Every time you have a wedding on your show, 30 people die horribly.
You know, we established that right in the first season with the Dothraki wedding. Wedding that doesn't have at least three deaths is a dull affair.
Right, yeah. No one's going to invite you to one, that's for sure. But I'm curious, I think King Joffrey, I was trying to think about it, I can't think of a character people have hated more. He was absolutely awful. Did you have any mixed feelings at all about killing Joffrey, or were you cool with it?
Well, of course, I killed him years ago in the books.
Yeah.
So at that time, we didn't actually have an actor playing him or something. Jack Gleason, who played Joffrey, was actually like the nicest guy in the world. I mean, it was a...
I can't imagine that. I can't imagine when you see that character and he's always saying things like, "What a nice little cat! Kill it!" It's then hard to believe that he's a really nice guy as an actor.
I think it's a good thing that I wrote the books before we started making the show, because when you make the show and you actually meet the actors, then it's harder to kill them, because you say, I'm going to make... Jack will be out of a job then.
And he seems so nice, and he told me he's buying a boat.
That's right.
I don't want to kill him.
But I've done all the killing years ago, so I don't have to worry about it.
Right, the show is just trying to catch up to the murders you committed years ago.
That's true. Although, to be fair, David Benioff and Dan Weiss, who are the showrunners, they're killing characters who are still alive in the books. So as bloody as I am, David and Dan are always turning things up to 11. So really, no one is safe. Even the book readers who say, "Well, this character is safe. He's not in any trouble because he's still in book 5." May have an unpleasant surprise when.
Now, was that an unpleasant surprise for you when you wrote the book and you really loved this character, and then they put a spear through his mouth? You know, is that?
I usually know about it because I actually work on the show and write one episode per season usually.
Sure.
So I have a little warning, but I do kind of squeal when I get the outline. I say, wait a minute, he's not dead in the books.
Right.
He's still alive in the books.
You're like, this is TV, pal, sit back and relax.
The actor asked for a raise, we had to do something.
They wanted air conditioning in their trailer, they're dead. This must have been, I don't know how you felt about it, this must have been a thrill. At the White House Correspondents' Dinner about a week ago, President Obama, in his routine, referenced the Iron Throne in the Game of Thrones.
That's right. And you know, we would gladly give him one. We have about 6 or 7 of them. We gave one to a guy in Brooklyn recently. So,
you give these away?
Well, they did. They had a big season 4 premiere at the Barclays Center. 7,000 fans were there, and we drew a seat number. So a guy from Hoboken won an Iron Throne.
Wow.
There's a guy in Hoboken sitting on the Iron Throne? A pizza will be ordered.
If I won one of those, I'd cut a hole in it and put it right over the toilet.
That's so great.
I just keep imagining a guy trying to get it home on the path tubes.
Pushing it up the stairs. You know what? That makes me want to get one from the show. I'd love to do an episode of this show where it's the same exact show, but I'm on an Iron Throne the whole show. But just it's engaging in celebrity banter. And then Andy can use it as a toilet. We should take a look, because it was really fun when President Obama referenced your show. Let's take a look.
This year, I've promised to use more executive actions to get things done without Congress. My critics call this the imperial presidency. Truth is, I just show up every day at my office and do my job. You got a picture of this, I think.